Jamie and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be talking about series 2 of Taskmaster New Zealand and whether or not it is better than the original, as loads of people are saying. So yeah, I'm really excited for this one. Yeah, let's just get straight into the video. So I did a review of the first series of Taskmaster New Zealand and I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a pretty good adaptation of the British one. I did have some minor complaints, which if you haven't seen my video, you can watch it. I'll put it up in a card if you want to watch it. I feel like most people were kind of on the same page as me, judging by the comments from the review video. Most people believing that it was pretty good with a few like outstanding moments, like the most outrageous costume task. And a lot of people thought that Jeremy didn't quite fit the role of the Taskmaster as well as Greg does. But most people, yeah, agreed that the tasks were good and that Paul Williams was kind of like really, really good, which I totally agree with. Taskmaster New Zealand Series 2, I thought would be like about the same level, but it is like absolutely incredible how funny it is. And lots of people are saying that it's better than the original or it's their favourite series of any Taskmaster like version ever, like including the original, which it's just amazing that they've managed to pull it off so well. And this video will kind of go into the strength of Taskmaster New Zealand and why it's such a good show, and also why it's such a good adaptation as well, because when you're watching it, you cannot tell at all that it wasn't like the original concept, like it wasn't their original idea, but it's just amazing how they've just done it. It's just incredible. So first I'm just going to give a little bit of information about Taskmaster New Zealand Series 2 if you haven't seen it, and in case you're wondering, this video will contain minor spoilers, so I'll be giving descriptions of tasks and descriptions of the Taskmaster contestants' efforts, but I won't go into detail about who wins tasks or anything like that. Taskmaster New Zealand features Jeremy Wells as the Taskmaster and Paul Williams as the Taskmaster's assistant. Obviously these were the same in Taskmaster New Zealand Series 1. And the guests this series are David Correos, Guy Montgomery, Laura Daniel, Matt Heath and Urzila Carlson. And one of the things that makes this series so good is the contestants and Paul and Jeremy as well, but like the contestants are really strong. So they have amazing chemistry, both kind of in the studio and in their teams. They've done the teams like excellently, like divided them up very, very well. Everyone works together hilariously. Like they've both got like strengths and weaknesses, and yeah, it's just the teams. I couldn't have thought of a better way to divide the teams up. And also the studio, I would say, is a lot better than the studio in series one. Personally, I prefer all of the contestants than last time, maybe the exception of Angela, because I did really enjoy Angela. But yeah, these five contestants are all just like amazing. So yeah, I didn't know any of them and I absolutely love all of them, which just proves that you don't need to know the contestants before for Taskmaster to be funny and to work. So David Correos, he is possibly one of the funniest Taskmaster contestants that we've ever seen. I genuinely love him. He has a breakdown like pretty much every episode. So when you're watching, you're kind of waiting to see what will make him break, which is really funny. And I saw an article about David Correos, like the Taskmaster contestant who snapped. It's incredibly accurate and very, very good article. I'll link it down below. And so the best thing about David, I would say, is that sometimes he has like really genuinely good ideas and he puts so much effort into it as well for it to go wrong at like the last minute, or like the yogurt task, I think, is the most famous example if you've seen it. Like he will, yeah, he has good ideas, but he messes it up at the last minute and just like breaks down, screams. He's just brilliant. Like I have no complaints about him whatsoever. Like he's just so hilarious to watch. And I just love how much energy he puts into it. Like he's not somebody who just kind of doesn't really care about it. Like he genuinely tries his best. He just completely misses the mark completely, which is just hilarious to watch. I feel like David is very unpredictable and you never quite know what he's gonna do, and I feel like sometimes he surprises himself, like when you're watching his kind of reaction to what he did, and he genuinely just is like, how, why did I do that? My favorite bit is when they did the diss track and David felt so bad about what he said about the other contestants. He gave them presents. Like he just genuinely just didn't expect, like he's not watching it, didn't expect to say that. And I just think it's just Oh, just so funny. I also love his reactions to the tasks. I think this series has definitely upped the kind of studio reactions to when they're watching the tasks, which is something that the original Taskmaster, the UK Taskmaster, is kind of not doing as much anymore, which I don't like because I really, really like the reactions, like seeing the contestants react to what's about to happen or what's just happened, and that is one of the funniest parts to me. So I love that they've kept that in, and I love just watching David's face when they reveal what task it is. It's just hilarious. So the second contestant was Guy Montgomery. Throughout the series he wears a bucket hat and a t-shirt with Paul Williams as like a school kid on, because yeah, it's just funny. He's just got great kind of banter with all of the other contestants, and he's really snarky, and he's very witty. He's so quick to kind of with retorts and everything. He's just really, really funny. He's a bit odd, but he has kind of like weird but hilarious energy. Yeah, he comes out with some like really like wacky sayings that I would say are probably on par with Mike Wozniak's like weird little quirks he has, like the way he says certain things. They're definitely quite similar in that way, but that's probably the only way that they're similar. Actually, no, I would say they're both quite chaotic. So yeah, and he's genuinely good at the tasks and enthusiastic about them. Which is very nice to watch. I love it when people are enthusiastic about the tasks and like genuinely love the concept of the show, so put their effort in that way. I would say possibly kind of like James Acaster-esque energy as well, which again, I love James Acaster, so yeah, I love Guy Montgomery as well. Laura Daniels is the third contestant, and she is possibly one of the best contestants at tasks, possibly ever, I want to say. I don't know, but yeah, she's very, very good at tasks, very good at thinking outside the box and coming up with genius solutions. It's in a way that it isn't like, you don't get tired of her doing well. Like, I feel like sometimes it's like, oh, come on, give other people a chance. But like, she just impresses me every single time that I'm like, yeah, I'm fine if she wins everything, because she's just genuinely really good. She's talented at like so many different things. I want to be in an escape room with her and Guy as well. Both of them in the escape room task were brilliant. And I also, she's musically talented as well. Like, she could sing, she could rap. Yeah, that just surprised me as well. Like, she's genuinely good at everything, but not in a kind of obnoxious way. Another thing I like about Laura is that she can be kind of like unpredictable at times, and she genuinely, she's got a really good ability to do the tasks in a funny way and also be successful at the tasks. One of my favorite things, like the bit that made me laugh the most that she's done, is the steal something task. Like, if you've seen it, you'll know what I mean. But like, the way that the joke like kept going, and she kept bringing it, like doing it again and again and again, it was just so funny. And yeah, they're just a genius task that she did. And Matt Heath is probably most calm contestant. He never seems to understand the tasks, or like he does, but it might take him a while. There's one like where he did the task the quickest, but he took so much time just talking to Paul to begin with that he actually like didn't do the task that quickly overall. But once he started, he was good. He's just very chill. He does some really funny things, and he's got some really good ideas. Yeah, I just love that he's just calm about it. He's like, okay, I'll do this task, but I'll have a bit of a chat first. Yeah, it's a great kind of contrast to the really chaotic energy we get from David and Guy, and even Laura as well. He has a really good dynamic with Jeremy, the taskmaster, because I believe they were friends, or they are friends, or work together, or something like that. I'm not 100% sure, but they're definitely friends. And a lot of the time, Jeremy will kind of like insult Matt, and yeah, which is just funny. They kind of have really good kind of play off each other, which I really like. And he was also in a band, like in New Zealand. I can't remember the name of the band, I'll put it up now, but yeah, so that means he's really good at the music tasks. And he genuinely surprised me, because obviously I didn't know him before, because you know, I'm not that familiar with New Zealand comedy or music or anything like that, which is a shame, because I definitely want to get into it more, because they are hilarious people. Last but not least is Urzila Carlson, and she's kind of, yeah, she's very out there. She's kind of crude, rude humour, but like, she doesn't go too far. I don't think I know a lot of comedians who kind of use, who are quite rude and crass a lot, kind of say it inappropriate times or kind of go a bit too far with some of the jokes, but she's really good at knowing when to bring that out. And she's really, really good dynamic with Paul. Half the time she is like flirting with him and like, you know, jokingly doing stuff like that. And then other times she's just like, oh, gotta get him out of my face kind of thing. Yeah, and she's originally from South Africa. So she brings another kind of different energy to it, which I really like. And yeah, I just never know what to expect with Urzila, which is kind of the same with every contestant here. But yeah, she's really good. And again, she's a good contrast to the first three that I mentioned, because she puts effort in when she wants to. Not that she doesn't put effort in any time, but sometimes she'll just be like, not half-ass it, but she'll do it in a funny way. I don't know how to to describe it, which again, so the teams are split up. So it's the first three, so the three younger ones, and then Matt Heath and Urzila Carlson together. And yeah, again, the dynamic between those three just going crazy and then these two just kind of going a bit slower. It kind of reminds me of like Joe Brand and David Baddiel. They're kind of what they were like. That is the kind of energy that we've got between the two teams. And as we've seen with Series 9 of Taskmaster, it was really, really, really funny. So yeah, those are the contestants. Very, very strong set of contestants. Definitely prefer these lot to Series 1, even though I did thoroughly enjoy Series 1. They're just all really funny in their own unique way. And yeah, because a lot of people, when kind of the Taskmaster contestants are released for each series, there's always people complaining that this series is going to be bad because I don't know anybody. And yeah, I can't lie that sometimes I'm a bit disappointed if I don't know anybody, but it doesn't mean it's going to be bad because the contestants can surprise you. You don't know, you're going in not knowing what to expect. And if anything, it introduces you to new comedians, and that's amazing. And yeah, Taskmaster New Zealand's proved that you do not need to know the contestants to enjoy it, because they are absolutely like, oh, they're just hilarious. So on to the Taskmaster and his assistant. I would say Jeremy has definitely improved on Series 1. His style is a lot more concrete. He's not as inconsistent as I would say he was in Series 1. He still isn't like Greg, but I'm totally okay with that. I don't think anybody's going to be like Greg because he is his own character. But Jeremy takes it a completely different approach. Jeremy is a bit kind of like calmer, a bit more diplomatic. Now, I wouldn't say Greg is mean in any way, but he can be a bit harsher than Jeremy. Jeremy is a lot more, yeah, just kind of chill about it. There's no point him trying to act like Greg if that's not his style. So I love that he's kind of done it in his own way. He's almost kind of like a bit monotone almost. I don't know if that's just thing, but he's a very good presenter of the show. And yeah, he's had some really standout moments. Yeah, I think he's really good. I know he is one of the biggest complaints about Taskmaster New Zealand, but I think everybody's just kind of trying to compare him to Greg and being like, well, he isn't acting like Greg. And it's like, that's fine. He doesn't have to act the way Greg does. And I think he does a really good job, especially in Series 2. He's a lot more consistent with his character. And I think he just really compliments Paul. They work very well together. I would say though, he's very similar to Greg in the way that sometimes the scoring makes no sense. So, Paul Williams, he is absolutely amazing. So he's a Taskmaster assistant. And the first episode of Series 1, I thought he was kind of copying Alex a bit too much, but I was proved wrong with Series 1 and he is just incredible this series. He has carried over his role brilliantly. He is just very, very funny to watch. I love his little quirks. And he isn't a copy of Alex at all. So they have some similarities, of course, because they're going to. But he's really created his own character, like Alex has. So I would say Paul seems a bit more sarcastic than Alex. Sometimes acts a bit more reluctant or clueless, almost. Like, he's just kind of watching in disbelief about what they're doing. He has some really funny studio moments. In there, when he's in the tasks, he's almost kind of like subservient to the Taskmaster, but like more kind of reluctant to do stuff for the contestants. Like, Alex will kind of do anything. But yeah, I just think Paul is probably one of the strongest parts of Taskmaster New Zealand, which is good because obviously he'll be in every series if it carries on, which I really hope it does. But another really strong point is the tasks. The tasks to me are very reminiscent of the early series of Taskmaster UK because they're like, they seem simple from the beginning and they get like deceptively harder. And the type of tasks where you're like, well, I could easily do that. And yet you're seeing the contestants struggle because it's not as easy as it seems. Yeah, the tasks. So a couple of really simple examples. So we've got, you know, open the tin of beans, eat the grape. So the actual task itself is very simple, yet doing that task is very hard. So the beans, there's like tons of cans and only one of them is beans. And eat the grape, but they're trapped inside the caravan and the grape is outside. So you see what I mean? Like, they're very similar to the early ones. They're not too complicated, but they're not too simple either. Whereas I feel like the later series of Taskmaster, the tasks kind of seem too complicated and like a bit too convoluted. Whereas with this, it's like, yeah, it's just a lot simpler. And that's what makes it funny for me. They've got a really good mix of, you know, regular tasks and creative tasks. Because I definitely prefer overall just your normal tasks. I feel like sometimes some series there's too many like drawing, painting tasks. They like to do, I would say it's definitely more like singing tasks like that, which not that I'm not a fan of, but they can not be as good. But all of the tasks have been really, really good. I don't think I've been disappointed by any. So is it better than the original Taskmaster? And I don't know, it's definitely, Taskmaster New Zealand Series 2 is definitely up there as one of my favourite series. Definitely on par with some of the strongest UK ones. I wouldn't say as a whole, comparing both Series 1 and 2 together, it isn't probably better than the whole of the UK one, but definitely on par. Definitely. If you haven't seen it, I strongly recommend watching it. Yeah, I haven't seen any complaints about it. Yeah, I don't know what I'll say. It's just genuinely so good. I would say it's definitely the best adaptation of anything ever. Like, they've just done such an amazing job just with every part of it. It's still got that style of the original Taskmaster, it's got the feel of it, but it's uniquely its own, which is just perfect. So yeah, that's the end of the video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, it'll be much appreciated, and comment down below your thoughts on Taskmaster New Zealand Series 2. And if you want to see more videos on Taskmaster, then subscribe to my channel. I have more videos out for you soon, and I've also got loads of other videos about Taskmaster, including a review of Taskmaster New Zealand Series 1. Thank you for watching. Bye.